when there is no more room in hell, the dead will walk the earth.
Oh, no tears, please. It's a waste of good suffering.
The blackest eyes, the devil's eyes.
I'd rather not spend the rest of this winter tied to this fucking couch!
Hey guys, I'm Neil, and welcome to my channel, Neon Black Reviews. Before we get into today's movie, if you would, go ahead and smash that thumbs up for me. That like really does help this video out here on YouTube, and I appreciate that support from you guys. And if you haven't already subscribed to Neon Black Reviews, go ahead and do that as well. Just click that subscribe button down there, click the bell next to it, and turn on those notifications, and that way you'll never miss a review. So today I'm going to be reviewing Prom Night. This one came out back in 1980. It was directed by Paul Lynch, and it stars Leslie Nielsen, Casey Stevens, and Jamie Lee Curtis. The description here on IMDb is, at a high school senior prom, a masked killer stalks four teenagers who were responsible for the accidental death of a classmate 6 years previously. So that's the basic idea behind this one. The film starts out 6 years previously, where we see these four kids. They're about 10 or 11 years old, and they're playing some sort of hide-and-seek game in what I thought was an abandoned schoolhouse. That's kind of what it looks like, but later in the film, it is referred to as a convent. So they're playing, like I said, some version of hide-and-seek in this old abandoned convent when three other kids walk up. One is a little older, about the same age as the kids that are playing in the school, and she has two younger siblings, and she has forgotten one of her books at school, so she goes back to get it, leaving the two younger kids there. And the little girl wants to go in and play with these kids, but the little boy's like, you know, I don't want to have anything to do with this. I'm just going to go on home. So that's what he does. And she goes into this convent to play with these kids. And long story short, they end up ganging up on her, trying to scare her. And she ends up accidentally falling out of a second story window to her death. And of course, with them being kids, afraid they're going to get in all kinds of trouble, they just make the decision that they're going to promise each other to never talk about it, never tell anybody what happened. So that's what they do. And now we're 6 years later. These kids are now in high school and getting ready for their senior prom. So, yeah, the first part of this movie, it spends a pretty good time, you know, just getting us, you know, introduced to everybody, kind of what's going on, you know, who's going to the prom with who still doesn't have a date, that kind of thing. Just all kinds of things, you know, you kind of expect in a movie like this. But it does take quite a while doing all of this. With not a whole lot going on, because just the way that this film is structured, nothing is going to happen to anybody until the prom is actually underway. So, like I said, you know, until we finally get to the prom, which is probably, I don't know, I didn't time it, but it's a pretty good way into the film. And we're just spending a lot of time with, you know, just the drama kind of things going on between these kids. We also learned that back, you know, when all of this happened 6 years ago, the police immediately suspected a sex offender as being who was responsible for this little girl's death. And when they went after him, he, of course, ran. And long story short there, he ended up getting burned very badly in some type of fiery accident. I don't know if it was his car that wrecked or something like that. But anyway, he's been basically like in a, you know, a burn unit, psychiatric ward kind of thing. For the past 6 years, and he has now escaped, and they are worried that he is going to come back to town for some sort of revenge. So that's kind of a little bit of the setup, you know, to try to, you know, to throw you off or to make you suspect, you know, who this killer might be, because again, this is a mystery style slasher. You know, we don't know who the killer is. It is up, you know, to us as the audience to figure out what is going on. But one thing about this whole, you know, sex offender guy being the killer, you know, being out for revenge, you know, it's not a very good misdirection, in my opinion. I mean, we as the audience, we know what happened at the beginning of the film. We know that this guy didn't have anything at all to do with the death of this little girl. So, you know, the idea that, you know, he could come back and want revenge, like on the town, that would make kind of, a little bit of sense, you know, in a horror movie. That would definitely be something, you know, that you could base a horror movie off of. Is this guy, you know, this guy coming back and just, you know, wrecking havoc on the whole town. But to actually come after these four kids makes no sense. Because first of all, he wouldn't even have known who they were. I mean, as far as we can tell from the movie, which is another thing that really doesn't make a whole lot of sense, is that these kids were never even questioned in this girl's death. I mean, there were two other kids that knew that they were there, but yet it doesn't appear that the police even asked them questions, you know, trying to see, you know, if they saw something, you know, maybe, you know, they did know who the killer was, something like that. So this whole angle of, you know, the crazy sex offender coming back for revenge, you know, just doesn't really make a whole lot of sense. So like I said, it's not a very good misdirection. Now, obviously, I'm not going to give away who the killer in this film is, but I mean, if you're doing the math, just from my description, you could probably figure out who it might be, because it had to have been somebody that was there that knew what happened. That knew what happened, so that they know, you know, so they know who to go after. But anyway, you know, I'll digress on that again. I'm not going to go into a whole lot of spoilers for, you know, you guys that haven't seen the movie. But like I said, not a whole lot happens until we get to the prom. And then when we get to the prom, one of the things that is going on, the girl that is played by Jamie Lee Curtis, I think her character's name is Kim. Let me check just to make sure. Yeah. Kimberly Hammond. She is now going out with one of those four original kids. There were actually three girls and a guy, and she's going out with this guy. But one of those other girls was previously going out with this guy, and you know, she's not too happy about their breakup and the fact that, you know, Kim is now in the picture. So she's got this little plan that she's gonna, you know, get together with the, you know, the school bully. Yeah, and they're going to play some sort of prank to embarrass her at the prom, which, does that sound familiar? maybe a movie that came out a few years before this one that was directed by Brian De Palma, based on a novel by Stephen King. Yeah, so they're definitely borrowing a little bit of an idea here from a movie that was called Carrie. But anyway, you got that going on as well. So that's just another little thing that's added into the mix. But anyway, we finally do get to the prom, and these kids start getting knocked off one by one. And, you know, and as far as the kills go, I mean, they're pretty decent. I mean, you know, it's pretty much, you know, what you would expect in a slasher film. They're not overly gory. The highlight kill of the film that comes, you know, there at the end is probably the goriest of all. But it's very quick. You really don't get to see a whole lot. But I mean, you know, overall, it's, you know, it's pretty well done. The other kills in the film, you know, while they're kind of brutal as, you know, to what actually happens to these kids, they're not overly graphic. They're kind of the, you know, the cutaway style kill, you know, where you see, you know, something coming at them and then it cuts away and then you see, you know, like a sliced throat or something like that. You don't actually see the kill all the way through. So yeah, that was a little disappointing about it. Another highlight of the film is Jamie Lee Curtis shows off her excellent disco dance moves. There's an extended dance sequence there at the prom where, she's showing how to move it, how to shake it. So, you know, that was also pretty interesting, especially if you're a fan of Jamie Lee Curtis like me. It was just, you know, it was amusing. But yeah, overall, I mean, this is not a great slasher film. I mean, I know it's a pretty famous one, but it's mostly because it's, you know, Jamie Lee Curtis is in this film. I mean, this is definitely, you know, not one of the best slasher films out there. It wasn't even the best slasher film of 1980. by a long shot, because, you know, Friday the 13th came out in 1980. Maniac came out in 1980. So we've definitely got some better slasher films, you know, just within this same year than Prom Night. But overall, I mean, it's not a bad watch. I do enjoy sitting down and watching this movie. It's got some moments in it that are pretty funny. You know, like I said, it's got some decent kills, even though we don't get to see, you know, the whole thing. It doesn't, you know, deliver the goods 100%. But it's, you know, it's just a fun little, you know, slasher flick. You know, as a fan of slasher films, a big fan of slasher films, you know, I can definitely sit down and watch it. I've seen it, you know, several times over the years, and every so often, you know, I'll pop it in just to watch it again. So it's really not that bad, but, you know, compared to, you know, some of the best slasher films out there, yeah, this one doesn't really match up. The other thing that it kind of does, too, which is pretty common in the 80s, you know, we got, you know, our cast is mostly, you know, mostly supposed to be like 16, 17-year-old teenagers. But yeah, everybody in the cast looks 30, so you got a bunch of 30-year-olds masquerading as high school students. And the guy that plays, you know, like the school bully, yeah, it's like, this guy looks like he's 40 years old, still in high school. But I guess if he's, you know, the character that he's supposed to be, yeah, he's probably still in high school because he ain't smart enough to graduate. But I do think at a certain age, they just kind of kick you out. But anyway, that's another little amusing thing, not just about this film, but, you know, about a lot of the slasher films, especially from the 80s, is you got a cast that is playing characters that are much younger than they actually are in real life. But anyway, overall, Prom Night's a pretty decent slasher. If you have never seen Prom Night, I would definitely, you know, recommend that you sit down and watch it. But just don't expect, you know, something on the level of a Friday the 13th, because it's definitely not that. As a rating, I'm going to give it a 6 out of 10. Again, it's definitely a watchable film, but it does have its flaws. So 6 out of 10 sounds fair to me. If you've seen Prom Night, drop me a comment. Let me know what you think about it. Do you like it? Do you not like it? What would you rate it? Always like to hear what you guys have to say. And if you haven't already, go ahead and smash that thumbs up for me, guys. That helps the video out. It helps me out, and I appreciate you doing that for me. And go ahead and subscribe to the channel as well. Just click that subscribe button, hit the bell next to it, turn on those notifications, and that way you'll never miss a review. So as always, guys, thanks for watching, and until next time, we'll see you.